Yeah. For a while. She just went for one then. Fuck. Not too centered on that stand. First kick, stone cold, no chug, no joke, first kick, and I started it, you know, I was a fucking liar, even this thing here, it was like a wreck, it still goes, right there, oh, here's a Honda, whoop, spokes are broken, fuck, oh yeah, that's no front brakes. Ignition's fucked, plastics are broken, throttle's a bit stiff and sticky, the kill switch hits dodgy. Fucking snuck, so that's the electric start there. I've had to hot wire it here, it's because they're fucking dog shit. So Husqvarna's. Here's our new mod. TS242. You know what that stands for? Shut up, you fucking birds! Stands for the shittest 242. We own three grizzlies. We've got this one. It's four-wheel drive. and got some stickers on it too. Off the bottom of the ignition because the steering column bearing went on it. So I hooked up this temporary switch here so that it'll run. And my brother smashed the rear tail light on it. Got a new one for it somewhere. You know the drill. If it's fucking red, keep it in the shed. Anything red, orange, black. Shit. And we all know what KDM stands for too, don't we? KDM stands for keep taking money. Look at this cactus. I'm gonna have to run something to prop this one up. This one here, it was right over here. I had to use some poly tape to prop the fucking thing up. And I have to end up doing the same for this one here. Fucking prop him up like that. And that one. Look at this fucking antenna up here. Gives us a bit of a story time about the fucking meter box situation that's been going on. I had to redo this downpipe here because some dodgy builder years ago he had busted the elbow that's under the concrete because that is the elbow that goes down and out. Duct tape around it. Yep, fucking duct tape. And we had a huge downpour of rain and water started bubbling up out of the ground. And I dug it up one day, not too long ago actually, to find a fucking big ass hole. So I just rerouted it down and out. And I'm gonna get some concrete to fill that hole in so that it's up there had basically no glue in it, nor did this one here. They were both pretty much off, and then all around here was cracked, so I put this thing around it and that sealed her up. Then we got another down pipe that had to fix. There's our one-eyed dog, one of them anyway, one of our dogs. He's the only one-eyed dog. So then, it's here, this one, it was all cracked around here, and this awning, or roofing, was added on, as well as this downpipe, and the same goes for that roofing over there and the downpipe as well. They were both added on, and they were added on about 4 years after the house was built. Which means the older the days get, the dodgier shit gets. I'm not really fucking happy, but anyway, I've got them all fixed and hopefully I won't have to fix them again. And hopefully I won't have to fix another fucking lawnmower too. Another fucking wobble. wobbly that deck is. Absolutely no good. So one thing I do like is having the fuel tank thing right here. You pop that off, see the front lens, pour it in. So the only thing I don't like is it's stiff as all hell. Six months 2019. So yeah, it probably is due for a service. And three, it's probably saying it's third service. Some compression there, but wouldn't call it a lot. But yeah, she's well over, probably, I don't know, minimum of 40 hours on that top end. And when I bought it, it had a little bit of, like, I don't know, 10 hours. On the top end. Just got 40 hours. So I'm to the top end. We're to the second top end by now, I'd say. And I got two-stroke push mower. You don't see those around anymore. Not much. They're fucking good, I'll tell you that. Got another one here.